الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, we have the class of tafsir from Surah Al-Baqarah from verse 174. verse 174 of Surah Al-Baqarah. قال الإمام الشيخ عبد الرحمن السعدي رحمه الله في قول الله عز وجل: إن الذين يكتمون ما أنزل الله من الكتاب ويشترون به ثمنا قليلا أولئك ما يأكلون في بطونهم إلا النار ولا يكلمهم الله يوم القيامة ولا يزكيهم ولهم عذاب أليم. أولئك الذين اشتروا الضلالة بالهدى والعذاب بالمغفرة فما أصبرهم على النار. ذلك بأن الله نزل الكتاب بالحق وإن الذين اختلفوا في الكتاب لفي شقاق بعيد. قال رحمه الله: هذا وعيد شديد لمن كتم ما أنزل الله على رسله من العلم الذي أخذ الله الميثاق على أهله أن يبينوه للناس ولا يكتموه. فمن تعوض عنه بالحطام الدنيوي ونبذ أمر الله فأولئك ما يأكلون في بطونهم إلا النار. لأن هذا الثمن الذي اكتسبوه إنما حصل لهم بأقبح المكاسب وأعظم المحرمات, فكان جزاؤهم من جنس عملهم. ولا يكلمهم الله يوم القيامة, بل سخط عليهم, قد سخط عليهم وأعرض عنهم, فهذا أعظم عليهم من عذاب النار. ولا يزكيهم, أي لا يطهره من الأخلاق الرذيلة, وليس لهم أعمال تصلح للمدح والرضا والجزاء عليها. وإنما لم يزكيهم لأنهم فعلوا أسباب عدم التزكية التي أعظم أسبابها العمل بكتاب الله والاهتداء به والدعوة إليه. فهؤلاء نبذوا كتاب الله وأعرضوا عنه واختاروا الضلالة على الهدى والعذاب على المغفرة, فهؤلاء لا يصلح لهم إلا النار, فكيف يصبرون عليها وأن لهم الجلد عليها. ذلك المذكور وهو مجازاته بالعدل ومنعه أسباب الهداية ممن أباها واختار سواها بأن الله نزل الكتاب بالحق. ومن الحق مجازاة المحسن بإحسانه والمسيء بإساءته. وأيضا ففي قوله نزل الكتاب بالحق ما يدل على أن الله أنزله لهداية خلقه وتبيين الحق من الباطل والهدى من الضلال. فمن صرفه عن مقصوده فهو حقيق بأن يجازى بأعظم العقوبة. وإن الذين اختلفوا في الكتاب لفي شقاق بعيد, أي وإن الذين اختلفوا في الكتاب فآمنوا ببعضه وكفروا ببعضه, أو الذين حرفوه وصرفوه عن أهوائهم على أهوائهم ومراداتهم, لفي شقاق أي محادة بعيد عن الحق, لأنهم قد خالفوا الكتاب الذي جاء بالحق الموجب للاتفاق وعدم التناقض. فمرج أمرهم وكثر شقاقهم وترتب على ذلك افتراقهم, بخلاف أهل الكتاب الذين آمنوا به وحكموه في كل شيء فإنهم اتفقوا وارتفقوا بالمحبة والاجتماع عليه. وقد تضمنت هذه الآية الوعيد للكاتمين لما أنزل الله المؤثرين عليه عرض الدنيا بالعذاب والسخط, وأن الله لا يطهرهم بالتوفيق ولا بالمغفرة. وذكر سبب في ذلك بإيثارهم الضلال على الهدى, فترتب على ذلك اختيار العذاب على المغفرة, ثم توجع لهم بشدة صبرهم على النار لعملهم بالأسباب التي يعملون أنها موصلة لها, وأن الكتاب مشتمل على الحق الموجب للاتفاق عليه وعدم الافتراق, وأن كل من خالفه فهو في غاية البعد عن الحق والمنازعة والمخاصمة, والله أعلم. In this ayah, Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 174, قال الله عز وجل: إن الذين يكتمون ما أنزل الله verily those who conceal what Allah has sent down of the book من الكتاب, those who conceal, those who hide from the people what Allah has sent down of the book, ويشترون به ثمنا قليلا, and they purchase a small gain therewith of worldly things, أولئك ما يأكلون في بطونهم إلا النار, they eat into their bellies nothing but fire, ولا يكلمهم الله, Allah will not speak to them on the day of resurrection يوم القيامة, ولا يزكيهم, and nor will he will Allah purify them, ولهم عذاب أليم, and theirs will be a painful torment, أولئك الذين اشتروا الضلالة بالهدى, those are they who have purchased error at the price of guidance, they purchase misguidance, deviation, disobedience over guidance, والعذاب بالمغفرة, and torment at the price of forgiveness, فما أصبرهم على النار, so how bold they are for evil deeds which will push them to the fire. ذلك بأن الله نزل الكتاب بالحق, that's because Allah has sent down the book, the Quran, in truth, وإن الذين اختلفوا في الكتاب, and verily الذين اختلفوا في الكتاب لفي شقاق بعيد, those who dispute as regards the book are far away in opposition. This ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the rule of the one who conceal the guidance from the creation of Allah Azza wa Jal. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْتُمُونَ مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهِ, verily those who conceal what Allah has sent down من الكتاب of the book. They conceal, they hide what Allah sent down of the book. The knowledge is with them, and this knowledge is not to them only, it's also to the others. Instead of passing it to the others, conveying it to the others, teaching this knowledge of Allah to the others as Allah taught them, they hide it from the others. Why are they doing that? وَيَشْتَرُونَ بِهِ ثَمَنًا قَلِيلًا, and purchase a small gain therewith of worldly things. They think if they convey the haq, they losing a worldly benefit, either leadership or any other things. Or money. So Allah said, أُولَٰئِكَ مَا يَأْكُلُونَ فِي بُطُونِهِمْ إِلَّا النَّارِ, they eat into their bellies, what is it? Bellies. Nothing but fire. They eat nothing but fire. In another ayah in Surah An-Nisa, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَأْكُلُونَ أَمْوَالَ الْيَتَامَى ظُلْمًا إِنَّمَا يَأْكُلُونَ فِي بُطُونِهِمْ, what is the ayah? Naran. Those who consume the wealth of the orphan, they only eat in fire. This is, as Sheikh Sa'd mentioned, jaza min jins al-amal. The reward is based on the action. When they eat haram, unlawful things, either the wealth of the people, especially the orphan, or they gain worldly life by hiding the book of Allah, the deen of Allah, from the people. In return, with Allah, Allah punished them to make them eat fire. Na'udhu billah. So in their stomach, fire. Al-jaza'u min jinsi al-amal. So they eat haram, it is they eat in fire. وَلَا يُكَلِّمُهُمُ اللَّهُ, and Allah will not speak to them. Allah Azza wa Jal is mad at them. Shaykh Sa'id said this is worse than even the punishment itself. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry with them, he's not talking to them. Subhanallah. وَلَا يُزَكِيمُ, and Allah is not purifying them, he's not forgiving them. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ, and there it will be a painful torment. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ اشْتَرَوْا الضَّلَالَ بِالْهُدَىٰ, they are those who have purchased error at the price of guidance and torment at the price of forgiveness. So instead of taking the guidance, they took the misguidance. Instead of receiving forgiveness, they take adab, torment. Allah said, فَمَا أَصْبَرَهُمْ عَلَى النَّارِ. Behold how bold they are, patient to the fire. يعني they cannot, but how brave they are. How brave they are to the fire. Allah Azza wa Jal and most of the people have no knowledge about them. This is another hadith. So in this ayat, this includes anyone who hired, including the one who hired the testimony. You are asked by the judge, what do you know about this and this? But because somebody gave you some money, he told you to hide or to witness against the innocent, you took the money, and whether you are the judge himself, you take bribe, or somebody else, then you hide the haqq, you know the truth, you know. شهادة وما يكتمها فإنه آثم قلبه. قال, and this Allah said here, أولئك الذين اشتروا ضلالة بالهدى والعذاب بالمغفرة, they purchase error at the price of guidance and torment at the price of forgiveness. How do they purchase a fire? How do they purchase a misguidance? Al-adab, punishment, instead of forgiveness. And Prophet ﷺ said in some hadith, all people will enter Jannah except those who refuse. They say, oh, who refused Jannah? Who is going to refuse paradise? He said, مَنْ أَطَاعَنِي دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَقَدْ أَبَىٰ. Whoever obeys me, he enters paradise. And whoever disobeys me, he refuses it. So disobedience, disobeying Allah Azza wa Jalla and His Messenger, is means clearly choosing fire. It's choosing fire. Preferring guidance, paradise over hellfire over paradise. Allah said in Quran, أُولَٰئِكَ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى النَّارِ, the disbelievers, they call to the fire. they call to the fire. Have you ever seen a disbeliever who says to the people, oh, people, go to the fire, to Jahannam? What's the meaning of the ayah? It means the disbelievers, they call people to that which leads to the fire. يدعون إلى النار. يدعون إلى النار. والله يدعو إلى الجنة. Allah call عز وجل His creation to the paradise. والله يدعو إلى دار السلام. Allah call to the house of peace. Is Jannah. So whoever disobeys Allah تبارك وتعالى means he chose hellfire. Whoever obeys Allah تبارك وتعالى's messenger means he wants paradise. Someone may disobey Allah Azza wa Jal, rather may commit even a major sin, and still he considers himself someone who wants paradise. He considers himself someone who doesn't want hellfire. He hates hellfire. If you say you love hellfire, you say, no, I hate it. A'udhu billah. Okay, but the action you do in it means you want hellfire. Means you don't want a Jannah. That's what it means, whether you understand or you don't understand. So, أُولَٰئِكَ, Allah said, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ اشْتَرَوْا الضَّلَالَةِ أي استبدلوا الضلالة بالهدى والعذاب بالمغفرة فما أصبرهم على النار. ذلك بأن الله نزل الكتاب بالحق. That's because Allah has sent down the book in truth. Allah has sent down the book to convey it to the other people, to apply it, and from applying to call it to the other. But they didn't do that. Then what's the wisdom of sending the Quran down? So the reason, the wisdom that Allah sent down the Quran is to apply and to follow it, and from that to call it to the others. Rather, they even gain in worldly life in the name of the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. فَمَا أَصْبَرَهُمْ عَلَى النَّارِ. So how strong they are, how patient they are in hellfire. يعني, how brave are they? وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ اخْتَلَفُوا فِي الْكِتَابِ لَفِي شِقَاقٍ بَعِيدٍ. And those who dispute as regards the book are far away in opposition. They differing. Those who oppose the Quran are differing. They have differences. They must have. Because Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet is what call people to unity and love. When they left it, they must be upon opposition, upon differing. قال الله تعالى ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب. This ayah is ayah. If one of us would understand this ayah, would apply, Allah Azza wa Jal Subhanahu save his sin from hellfire and make his sin from the people of Jannah. One single ayah, Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 177. But who can apply it except those whom Allah chose them? Those who take this religion serious. Those who truly fear Allah Azza wa Jal. In secret and in public. Allah said, ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر والملائكة والكتاب والنبيين وآتى المال على حبه ذوي القربى واليتامى والمساكين وابن السبيل والسائلين وفي الرقاب وأقاموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة والموفون بعهدهم إذا عاهدوا والصابرين في البأساء والضراء وحين البأس أولئك الذين صدقوا وأولئك هم المتقون. قال الله عز وجل said, ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب. It is not البر, piety, righteousness, and every act of obedience to Allah, the righteous not is not that you turn your faces towards the east and or the west. That's not the righteousness. Who remembers what this ayah relate to? Talks about. Yes. Changing the Qibla. What verse Allah mentioned changing the Qibla? Because there is a reason I ask this question. So this ayah, as Imam Ibn Kathir mentioned, and others of ulama tafsir, Allah said, Azza wa Jalla, laysa al-bir. The righteousness is not, and to wallu wujuhakum, to face your faces towards the east or towards and the west. They say this, it means Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying that the righteousness is not where you're facing to, the face is always to be to Bayt al Maqdis or always to be to the Kaaba. That's not the issue. So this ayah, what's the ayah it relate to? Yes. Yes. قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجِهِكَ. Those verses, almost how many verses pass? At least, yes. Yes. 30 ayah, close to 30 ayah. And then other rules came, other information, other guidance, other. Then Allah brought it. So Quran is connected to. Yes, yes. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Azza wa Jal, commands His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the believers to face their faces in salah, in prayer, towards the Kaaba, some people objected that. The Jewish and some weak Muslims. Jazakallahu khair. They objected that. They say, their argument. One day facing this, one day facing that. What? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَيْسَ الْبِرَّ أَن تُوَلُّوا وُجُوهَكُمْ قِبَلَ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ. The issue is not where you face. The issue is to obey Allah. If you were doing, you were praying towards the Bayt al-Maqdis, because Allah commanded you, it's He, Azza wa Jalla, is commanding you to face the Kaaba. And there is another ayah. Allah said, لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ. When some people thought that what matters is how many animals they slaughter, they sacrifice, how much number, regardless fear of Allah, regardless ikhlas, doing for Allah. Allah said, لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا ولا دماؤها. What reaches Allah is not the blood, is not the meat, the flesh of the animal you slaughtered. What reaches Allah and what considers Allah is التقوى منكم, piety, righteousness, the piety, fear of Allah, ikhlas. So in this ayah it relates to those verses. Sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran brings the doubt of the disbelievers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings the answer of that doubt after several verses. So if you really need to know, the Quran is connected to. Is connected to is a book of Allah Azza wa Jal. I surprised whenever I remember this person, Alhamdulillah, who became Muslim, but was non-Muslim, was from the atheist, a professor. Allah guide him to Islam, Alhamdulillah. Subhanallah, I surprised when he talked about how he became a Muslim. And he mentioned that when he started reading the Noble Quran, he didn't believe the existence of Allah Azza wa Jal. And he's very proud, he's very arrogant. He's a professor, he's this. So he said when he recited the first chapter, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم, guide us to the straight path. He said the author was very smart. He's like, he's telling us, telling me that there is a path of guidance, he said. And then he said, I don't pay attention to, I continue. And then he said, next chapter, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدَى. This is the book, there is no doubt, it is the guidance. He said, oh, I understand now. So the guidance he tell me in the first chapter, he said in this chapter, it is the Quran. He said, I started looking then, he started looking carefully. Can you believe that? Subhanallah. Wallahi, have you ever seen that Surah Al-Baqarah and Fatiha has that connection? Regardless what this man said, but this is general. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابِ, this is the book. ذَلِكَ, نعم. At the ulama one day, this ذَلِكَ, this is. And if it said ذَلِكَ اسْمُ إِشَارِ الْبَعِيدِ, that is, means because of the high position of Quran. Is the book, it is the book. لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدَى. It is the guidance. Hudan, it is the guidance. So, يعني, the Quran is the guidance, and the guidance is not taken from this man. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. فاتحة. Oh Allah, guide us to the straight. But what is الصراط المستقيم? ما هو الصراط المستقيم? الإسلام. وأن هذا صراطي مستقيما وإنك لتهدي إلى صراط مستقيم. What guy, Prophet Sunni got people to the straight path. What is this? It's Islam. It's the Islam. So the guidance mentioned in Fatiha is the Quran. But the point is how يعني, so to understand Quran يعني, you need to look it carefully and look the relation, even the ayah itself, the beginning and the ending has connections. The surahs, each surah. Wallahi al-Azim. There are books, Tanasukh al-Ayat, the ulama, the people of knowledge, they write down. So, even though this ayah is after almost 30 verses, but this part, لَيْسَ الْبِرَّ أَن تُوَلُّ وُجُوهَكُمْ قِبَلَ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ, relating to those verses, in which Allah mentioned that He changed the direction of the prayer. So the religion, obeying Allah, the religion is not the way the person likes or the way he feels, the way he likes. No, it's the way Allah commands. When you find yourself following what Allah commands, regardless your feeling and your community and the way you like it, now you are the one who follows the haq. You're the one who follows the guidance of Allah. But if you take from the religion which goes with you, with your way, and if it goes another way, you leave it, this is not submission to Allah Azza wa Jal. لَيْسَ الْبِرَّ أَن تُوَلُّوا وُجُوهَكُمْ قِبَلَ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ. It is not albir, it's not righteousness that you turn your faces towards the east and or the west in prayers. وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ, Allah mentions, Subhana, from here, what is the righteousness? Who is the righteous person? If all people get together and they tell you are not righteous, you bad, but Allah tells you are righteous, who you are asking other than Allah? If everyone say good about you, but you don't find your qualities here, you find the opposite, what the praising of the people benefit you. Allah said, وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ. But the righteousness is, مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ. Albir is the one who believes in Allah. آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ, the one who believes in Allah. The ulama have, people of knowledge have books on only that word. The one who believes in Allah. Believe in Allah, the people of knowledge, they divide it into believe in Allah? What should we believe? What should we believe in Allah? When you say, "Oh, Muslim, I believe in Allah," you believe in Allah? Yes, I believe in Allah. What do you mean? What do you mean? It should be very clear. This is the foundation of Islam. Many Muslims, if you ask them, when you say, "I believe in Allah," what do you mean? Wallahi, many of them, they don't know what they mean, what it means. What's the meaning of "I believe in Allah"? Azza wa Jal. The people of knowledge, like Sheikh Muhammad bin Salih al-Uthaymeen said, "Al-Iman billahi yatadamman al-Iman إفراد الله تعالى بما يختص به من ربوبيته وألوهيته وأسماء الحسنى وصفاته العلى." I believe in Allah means you believe in Allah when you single out Allah in His Lordship, in His worship, and in His names and attributes. In another word, you believe the oneness of Allah in Lordship, that He is the Rabb, the Lord, no other Lord. And that you believe the oneness of Allah in worship, means La ilaha illallah, that none has right to be worshipped but Allah. And the oneness of Allah in His beautiful names and attributes. You believe all the names and descriptions of Allah the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to believe it. The way His Messenger Muhammad sallam conveyed to the people, the way the companion used to believe it, which is to believe all the names, all the description of Allah, without twisting it, without ماذا, making any tamthil or ta'atil or takyif, without resembling, likening anyone to Allah Azza wa Jal. So, well, al-birr is the one who believes in Allah. Question, did the idol worshippers, Abu Jahl and his group, did they used to believe in Allah? Idol worshippers, Quraysh, those who used to worship idols, did they used to believe in Allah? If you say yes, you're mistaken. If you say no, you're mistaken. It depends what type of believing Allah means. If it means believing the Lordship of Allah, that Allah exists, He's the creator, He's the owner, He's the controller, yes, they believe. If it means believing in Allah, to worship Allah alone, no, they didn't believe, they refused it. They rejected. The cause of all their fight was because of La ilaha illallah. When it comes to the asma wa sifat, the names of Allah, the description of Allah, they believe some and they disbelieve some. For instance, they believe the name Allah, but they disbelieve the name Ar-Rahman. Some Muslims think that the idol worship is the enemy of Allah, those who fight the Prophet ﷺ, that they were not believing that Allah existed. Allah, they were believing. When it comes to the Lordship, Tawheed Rububiyyah, the Lordship of Allah, which means Allah is the creator, the owner, the control of everything, Quraysh used to believe it. They never believe that for anyone other than Allah. Many ayat in Quran. Just one verse in Surah Yunus. قُلْ مَنْ يَرْزُقُكُمْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Say, oh, the Messenger of Allah Muhammad, to them, means to the idol worshippers, who provides you from up and from the earth, from the sky and from up and from the earth? أَمَّا يَمْلِكُ السَّمَعَ وَالْأَبْصَارِ. Who owns the hearing and the vision? وَمَنْ يُخْرِجُ الْحَيَّ مِنَ الْمَيِّتِ وَيُخْرِجُ الْمَيِّتَ مِنَ الْحَيِّ. Means who gives life and causes death. Not only those three mentions. وَمَنْ يُدَبِّرُ الْأَمْرِ. Who control the matters? Who control the affairs? فَسَيَقُولُونَ. They will say what? Allah. Allah said that. They didn't say Uzza, Manata, Lata. They didn't mention. They didn't say the angels. This is because this is rububiyyah, this is lordship. They say Allah is the one who provides us, the one who gives us life, causes death, the one who controls the mars, it's Allah. rather sometimes they used to swear by Allah. ولئن سألتهم من خلقهم ليقولن خلقهن العزيز العليم. So توحيد الربوبية, believing that Allah exists, He is the creator, He is the owner, He is the controller, is one of the tawheed, one of the rights of Allah. But that's not all. The second haqq of Allah, second aspect of tawheed, is to believe Allah's subhanahu wa ta'ala uluhiyya, meaning to single out Allah in worship. And really, the one who believes tawheed al-rububiyya, the oneness of Allah in lordship, that Allah is the creator, the owner, the control of everything, he must accept, if he is honest, Allah to be the only true God. Allah to be the only one to be worshipped. Because he is the one who gives. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. If you say all mercy, and that's what idol worship were saying, وَلَئِن سَأَلْتَهُمْ وَلَئِن سَأَلْتَهُمْ قُلْ أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إن أرادني الله بضر هل هن كاشفات ضر أو أرادني برحمة هل هن ممسكات رحمتي قل حسبي الله. So if they are asking those beside Allah you worshiping, if Allah withhold the good from me, can they send it? They say no. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send mercy to me, can they hold it, withhold it? They say no. Then say, حسبي الله, أي كافي الله. Then Allah is sufficient to me. Allah suffices me. عليه توكلت. To him alone I depend. I rely on. I put my trust on. So if they cannot give me what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala establishes, and they cannot stop what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving to me, then what is their role? Nothing. Don't waste your time with them. Subhanallah bihamdi subhanallah al-azim. This is tawheed al-uluhiyya. Idol worship, they refuse that. They say, no, 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 yes. Rububiyya is for Allah. Lordship is for Allah. But the ibadah, the acts of worship, there are good servants of Allah, righteous, na'am, saints, angels. They're very close to Allah than us. So we worship them to get as close to Allah. So they are our intercessors. They intercede for us. We're sinful. We can't go straight to Allah. This is what they used to say. مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ وَيَقُولُونَ هَؤُلَاء, in the same surah, Surah Yunus. وَيَقُولُونَ هَؤُلَاء شُفَعَاؤُنَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. They say, these are our intercessors with Allah. Allah said, قُلْ أَتُنَبِّئُونَ اللَّهَ بِمَا لَا يَعْلَمُ فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَلَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Are you mentioning to Allah that which is, he doesn't know it in the heaven and the earth? You're telling Allah that what he doesn't know in the heaven and in the earth, meaning it doesn't exist. So, until today, the same ideology of the idol worshippers are being done by many people who keep on saying La ilaha illallah. But they don't know the meaning of La ilaha illallah as the idol worshippers they know. Idol worship, when they knew the meaning of La ilaha illallah, which is to worship Allah alone, and they were not going to do that, they refused to say the word. But today you find people who say La ilaha illallah, but wallahi they're doing the same thing idol worshippers were doing, of worshipping the dead, calling the saints grave worshippers. They go to the dead body, they say, oh Sheikh, oh Sheikh, oh Sheikh, we need life, we need health. The wife doesn't give birth. This didn't take place. Subhanallah. Today I'm going to work, make sure I get job, I make money, I make profit. They're talking to a dead. He's the one who buried him. And maybe he married his wife after him. When the iddah finished, he married, she's his wife. حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. He calling Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jailani in English. Sheikh Abdul Qadir never learned English. Allahu A'lam, even if he heard that. They call Sheikh Abdul Qadir in Urdu. in France, in Italy, in all over the all languages, from the ocean, from the sky, from the airplane, from the jungle of Africa, Pacific, everywhere, name in DC. They call Shah Abdul Ghadir Jailani. A'udhu billah. Ayu aqli wa ayu deen. Ya Hussein, the same thing. The Rafida, Ya Hussein, Ya Hussein, Ya Ali, Ya Ali. Ali, who Ali? Radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa ardaah. But the, يعني, it's amazing. نسأل الله السلام والعافية. نسأل الله السلام والعافية. نعوذ بالله من الضلال. نعوذ بالله من الضلال. So this is reality. الإيمان بالله, this is the most important thing to learn and to teach. Is the foundation of the deen. Prophet ﷺ was teaching people al-Iman billah before the salah was obligated, the five prayer, at least 10 years or close to 10 years. There was no jihad in those 10 years, jihad in hand. There was no ماذا, Ramadan. There was no Hajj. Drinking alcohol was lawful. Hijab was not mandatory. A lot of things. But al-Iman billah, the first word Prophet ﷺ said to the people, he gathered them, أيها الناس قولوا لا إله إلا تفلحوا. Oh mankind, say لا إله إلا الله. None has the right to be worshipped but Allah to succeed. Worship Allah alone. That is what they refuse. So, Shaykh al-Albani has محاضرة التوحيد أولا. يعني the tawheed first. نعم, understanding first لا إله إلا الله, and then understanding محمد رسول الله, and then understanding صلاة, understanding زكاة, fasting and the like. أركان الإيمان, أركان الإسلام, as في حديث جبريل. هذا جبريل أتاكم يعلمكم دينكم. الله عز وجل سير ولكن البر من آمن بالله. So the birr, the righteousness is man amina billah. So a Muslim, the person should believe in Allah, and it means believing his ar-rububiyyah, his lordship, and that he alone subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of everything, the owner and the controller. Also, believing Allah means believing His uluhiyyah, that He is the only true God, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And anyone being worshipped beside Allah is falsehood, is false God, shaitanic made gods. It's not true gods. ذلك بأن الله هو الحق وأن ما يدعون من دونه هو الباطل. So whatsoever they call Him beside Allah is باطل, is falsehood. Only Allah has right to be worshipped because He has the Azza wa Jal, He is the Rabb, He is the Lord. And also believing in Allah means believing in His Asma al-Husna wa Sifat al-Ula, believing His beautiful names and His descriptions. Some people, they refuse to accept, to believe the names and the description of Allah. For instance, if you, they say Allah is everywhere. How you say Allah is everywhere? It's in the Quran, it's in the Sunnah, many ayat, many hadith that Allah Azza wa Jal subhanahu wa ta'ala is above His creation. Allah Azza wa Jal rose over His throne. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is not in His creation, iyadan billah, nor the creation of Allah Azza wa Jal are in Allah, a'udhu billah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ba'inun min khalqihi. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to believe all the names of Allah. Allah mentioned in the Quran He has hands. He mentioned in more than one ayah that He created Prophet Adam with His two hands. To believe it. Don't say no, Allah doesn't have hands. A'udhu billah. How you say no? And Allah said that. قُلْ أَنْتُمْ أَعْلَمُ أَمِ اللَّهِ. And the like. all the description attributes, as long as it is sound, it's authentic, it's in the Quran or in the sound Sunnah. And at the same time, know that Allah is unique. Allah is unique, subhanahu. Laysa kamithli shay. None is like Allah, Azza wa Jal. Naam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala huwa ahadun as-samad. Laysa kamithli shay. None is like Allah, Azza wa Jal. No one resembles Allah. No one equivalent to Allah. No one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala huwa al-khaliq. He is the creator and the rest are the creation. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And all the names and description of Allah shows the greatness of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is believing in Allah. Ulama, they have books. What book you remember about Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah, for instance? What book do you remember? Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah, to worship Allah alone only. La Kitab al-Tawheed, alladhi huwa haqqullahi ala al-abid, Shaykh Muhammad Abdul Wahab. Whole book is about the one aspect of Tawheed, Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah. How about Tawheed al-Asma wa Sifat? Yes? Aqid al-Wasitiyya. No, there is a book only for Tawheed al-Asma wa Sifat. Aqid al-Wasitiyya also have other aspects of manhaj issues, aqid issues. Barakallahu fiqh. Al-Qawa'id al-Muthla fi Asma illahi Allah husna. There is a book more bigger. This is principles. With a very old scholar. Not our time. He died. Yes. مختصر العلو للإمام الذهبي. طيب. العلو للذهبي. Excellent. جزاك الله خير حسين. كتاب التوحيد. Then same name. الله أعلم. Maybe Shaykh Muhammad Wahab took from there. الله أعلم. كتاب التوحيد وإثبات صفات الرب عز وجل للإمام صاحب الصحيح ابن خزيمة. صاحب الصحيح ابن خزيمة. The Shaykh of Imam Ibn Hibban. The big عالم محدث. He has that book. Subhanallah. When you read that book, it's two volume. The way he talk, the Salaf talk less. The talk of the Salaf, you know, the very short talk. People our time, they talk a lot in general. That author, when you see Ibn Khuzayma, he talking like someone who lives now. How he put in detail, and he give examples, he bring ayat, he argue with them. It's a noble book. And this is Tawheed, many books. Naqdu al-Bishr al-Mirrisi li Uthman bin Sa'id al-Darimi min ajwad al-kutub. Aqidah Wasitiyya, al-Hamawiyya, the books of Ahl-Sunnah. Also, the ulama, since Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, okay, Tawheed al-Rububiyyah is believed even by the idol worshippers, they don't write that separate. Even though nowadays, because of the atheists, mulhidun, yakthuruna akthar, people, they give talks, yeah, talk about the Imam Dahlawi, al-Muhaddith, al-Hindi, he has a book, yaruddu fihi al-Mulhidin, he refusing the atheists, those who deny the existence of their Lord, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu a'lam, wa sallallahu wa sallam, barak ala nabiyyina Muhammad.